Hi friends, this is Seema here today again. Welcome to my channel. And today we are doing the third part of our bookshelf tabletop bookshelf build. Today I'm planning to finish this. Let's hope that we are able to do that, because I will be first sanding it down. Yesterday we added putty and wood filler, so I have to just go ahead and sand it down, and then I will go ahead and start adding paint. Then the first coat of paint will need about 2 to 3 hours, 4 hours to dry, because luckily enough the sun is out today, so there is a little bit of heat in the air and less humidity, but still let's hope we get the right results. And without further ado, let me just start off. I have all set up. Okay, so here you see me sanding. I am using a 220 grit. If you have questions, guys, please do write to me in the comments below, and I will surely reply back in case you have any questions regarding such this kind of video or this particular project or any other. And I would also like to know, if you like this kind of videos, please let me know in the comments below, and I'll be sure to make some such content. And also I am planning to make more makeover videos. The almirah you see at the back of me, that black thing, I am planning to make over that. It's not going to be a major makeover, it's just I'll be, you know, redoing it in a new finish. And so if you would like to see it, please leave a comment saying yes. And if you like this content, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. If you are new here, welcome, and I hope you are liking what you see in here right now. So once I was done sanding, I have gone ahead and used a vacuum cleaner to just get off all the sand that is remaining. Now after this, I also went back and did some sanding with the sheet, you know, because all the corners and everything needed to be done. So I've gone ahead and used a sanding paper and on a block of wood to go ahead and clean it. So all the corners need, because the orbital sander is round, it doesn't clean, you know, the corners properly. So now here you see me mixing the paint, and I've used turpentine oil to thin down the paint. Now my coat is not very even, because I wanted that wood textured look, or a light grainy. I wanted to create grains in this plywood, which does not really have grains. So I have done very uneven textured paint on the top. So, and you will see me make it more and more uneven. I will add different colors. I added some black paint and turpentine oil in the brown, golden brown enamel that I was using. I added some black enamel and darkened the paint to give some dark areas and light areas in the wood to create that wood look. So this is the first base coat that I did with just the thinned out paint. Now by no means I'm saying that I'm an expert. As I said, this is I'm just doing these projects as a home, and I'm learning along the way. There are lots of mistakes that I did, or rather not mistakes really, but things that I got to know, that you know, sanding is a very, very important step, because if you don't sand your piece properly, you might not realize it, but once you go on to put on your paint, that's when you see all the messiness and comes to the fore. So just make sure that the sanding for any project should be very proper. You need to go ahead and sand it properly. Here you see my paint is very uneven, dark, light, but that's the kind of look I was going for. So that's why in fact my brush was an old brush, and that's why I was using it, because it would not give a very smooth finish. So I had mixed some more paint and added the back, and then I go ahead and layer it a couple of times. So as I was saying earlier, guys, please do write in the comments below if you like this new content that I've created, or this type of videos. If you don't, then I will see what
more kind of video. I would like to know what kind of videos would you like to see from me. And if you're new to my channel, I make crafting videos, DIYs, and this is the first furniture makeover that I'm doing on video. I do it otherwise. If you follow, like, you can see my other work on Instagram. Please do follow me there as well and connect with me. And if you get inspired by any of my projects to create anything, please tag me with as home hashtag DIY. I would love to hear guys, connect with you guys there as well as in the comments below. And if you like this content, please consider subscribing. So here I am just putting the darker paint in patches and not really completely. I'm just doing it in certain areas, leaving some light areas and creating some dark textures. Because again, as I said, I wanted to go with the, you know, wood grain kind of a look. I also used this texture tool, wood grain texture tool from... it's a rubber tool. I purchased it from on Amazon. If you guys would like, I can leave the link in the description below and you can get it from there. You know, it's a very inexpensive tool and it gives a good great texture of wood grains. So here you see me just adding those touches. Now there will be a final reveal to this video after the finishing. After this video, the final reveal on the table and how I'm using it will come next week sometime, because I need to prepare the area where this is going to go, and this paint also needs a couple of days to dry cure completely. After that, I'll put a coat of polyurethane varnish on it, and then only after that, as you see, I have smudged my paint myself, and then I had to go back and redo that part where I'm putting my hands every now and then. So I had to refinish that area, but that's okay. As I said, wood grain texture or wood texture is very forgiving. So for the final reveal, you will see it from, next week, and I will also have a tutorial for there again is my son trying to talk to me. Okay, this is the final piece where I've left it. I have to varnish it. There'll be a little bit of a, maybe, you know, smudge. As I said, I have to go back and do that area again. You can see there's a good, like, look. I used the tool. It creates a good texture, actually. And if you like this video, please share with your friends or anybody who might be interested. And I thank you guys for watching and for your support. Your support motivates me to keep making such videos. Have a wonderful day ahead, and thanks for spending some time with me. I'll see you soon again. Bye bye.